Hi, my name is Dylan Bruno, and I'm sorry I couldn't be there to stand up and speak about Bun and embarrass him in person, so I'm gonna have to do it from far away. Bun was lucky enough to have the opportunity to do so at my wedding, so I feel like I owe him a little bit. But I do want to say for a minute, first of all, on a serious note, that I am very proud of Bun and all of his achievements at the restaurant and in his life because truly, Bun's development and evolution is mirrored by the development and evolution of Mia's. And I just think that as he grows and experiences, so does the restaurant. And as the restaurant grows and experiences, so does Bun. And I am really proud of what he's created there. It's a truly unique experience. If you haven't been there yet, you absolutely must go. There's a reason that he's been written up in every single gastronomical publication that exists on this planet, and he's won, just about every food award there is to win three or four times over. If you take a look at him, you'll see his head is rather large, and that's from all those awards, which are well deserved, I must admit. But anyway, I think it's important to understand Bun's journey, where he came from, where he's been through, and I think that that will help you to understand his expression as it's come out in the restaurant. So I've put together a short little photo essay of Bun's life, what he's been through. And I mean, the most amazing thing to me about Bun is that he's half Japanese, half Chinese, who's come to America, and he's really just broken down all cultural barriers. I mean, he really is the Asian everyman. And I mean, he has so many different faces. He's been through so much in his life. I mean, almost unrecognizable from one era in his life to another. So I've put together this photo journal. I'd like you to take a look at it. I've explained each of the phases of his life, and I hope that you get to know him much better as a human being and an individual who is, as successful and what a creationist he really is. Bun, I'm proud of you. And you deserve this award, and I wish I could be there to give you a big hug and shake your hand. Congratulations.
See, Bun grew up in a traditional Japanese family, traditional at least in all ways but one. His mother married a Chinese man at a time when socially, a cross-cultural marriage such as this was highly discouraged. So Bun's maternal grandfather was always fighting with his father. This didn't bode well for their future in Japan, so Bun's mother and father decided to pack the family up and move to America, land of peace and tolerance and diversity. Once here, they experienced the typical American dream. Bun was given a great education, and when he was through, he began to travel the country to see all that it had to offer. He did a short stint as a model for such products as Bohemia Beer, Camel Cigarettes, and Bed Bath & Beyond patio umbrellas. As a model, he gained a keen sense of fashion and even learned to tie a tie. Disgruntled with the lack of a cerebral challenge in modeling, Bun opted to join a boy band and did a short stint there until they were overshadowed by Menudo, at which time Bun ended up joining the military, where he learned structure and discipline, as well as how to treat his superiors. Soon, Bun realized he wasn't cut out for any of these lifestyles, and he gave up all of his worldly possessions and began a journey. This journey finally led him to the top of a mountain where he found peace and total enlightenment, as well as the strength of 10 men. Bun eventually found his home, living and fishing the waters of the Yangtze, where he remained for several years. Until one day when he grew weary and decided to pack his bag and head home. He couldn't have been happier or more fancy-free. Of course, the only one who was unhappy was his sister, who immediately put him back in his place, which ultimately ended up being getting his hands wet in the family food service industry. He learned to do the shopping, as well as the ordering, began to experiment with different foods and also alternative cooking methods. He continued to practice martial arts and found that he was happy and once again fancy free. His achievements at the restaurant brought him many accolades, and I now consider him a man of wisdom, strength of character, and who knows where we'll find Bun Lai next. Congratulations, Bun. I'm proud of you. You are an amazing individual.
I know just how to whisper, and I know just how to cry. I know just where to find the answers, and I know just how to lie. I know just how to fake it, and I know just how to scheme. I know